We got a good session for all. Who's ready? Y'all can do better than that. Who's ready for session 4, a Georgia FFA State Convention?
That's more like it, Willie.
You know, Jake, we've been up here talking a whole lot. You know what I mean?
I agree. I'm telling you, I think we should let somebody else talk.
I think so, too. Let's go down there to the delegates, and let's see what they think about convention, all right?
Okay, let's head on down here. Let's see. So everybody start thinking of an answer. What do you love most about convention? Somebody, what do you love most about convention? I have a hand right here. Right here, what do you love most about convention?
Getting to spend time with my chapter.
Getting to spend time with her chapter. Everybody, power clap on 3, 1, 2, 3.
All right, I'm over here, Jake. I'm with Lauren Wheeler. Lauren, could you please stand up for me? Introduce yourself.
I'm Lauren Wheeler. I'm from the East Lawrence FFA chapter.
Gotcha. And what's your favorite thing about State Convention?
Being here with all my friends.
Oh, so everybody say, oh.
That's a good one. I got one here, Willie. What do you love most about convention? First of all, introduce yourself.
My name is Brooke Shelton.
Brooke Shelton, where are you from, Brooke?
Bear Creek Middle School chapter.
Bear Creek Middle School chapter. What do you love most?
I love spending time with my chapter and getting to know new people.
That's what I'm talking about. Everybody give her a power stomp on 3, 1, 2, 3.
All right, I'm here with my buddy from Applin County. Now, could you introduce yourself to us?
My name is Nate Barnes from the Applin County FFA chapter.
There you go. Now, Nate, is this your first convention?
Yes, sir.
That's awesome. Everybody say, oh, yeah. So what's your favorite thing about convention so far?
Just seeing all the FFA kids together in one place, just enjoying themselves and having fun.
There we go. Everybody give him a big power clap. 1, 2, 3.
That's what I'm talking about. Let's do one more, Willie. I've got one right here. Introduce yourself.
I'm Gabe Hill from Athens Christian.
This is Gabe Hill. Everybody say, hey, Gabe. Gabe, tell us, what do you love most about convention?
Not sleeping at all.
Not sleeping at all, Willie. You hear that?
I feel that one.
I'm telling you, man. Well, let's head back up here. Let's talk about what we're going to do this session. Willie, I think this is probably one of my most favorite sessions. What do you think?
I agree.
I'm telling you, we have got some great stuff coming up. We are going to hear from our state superintendent, Superintendent Richard Woods. We are going to hear from our South Region Vice President, Mr. Dawson Adams. We're going to get to hear who the winner of the FFA talent competition is. Let me hear you say, oh yeah, if you're excited to hear that. Uh-huh, I know I am. We're going to get to recognize the new chapter charters, National FFA Week Observance Awards, and National Chapter Awards. And then, you know what else we're going to do, Willie?
I do. We're going to hear some Bulls theme songs. Oh, we're going to have some nervous people over there.
Oh, yeah. We're going to hear the NomCom results, and that is what I'm looking most forward to, and recognizing all of these chapters' hard work. I'm telling you, it's going to be awesome. But in the meantime, I think we have some T-shirts, Willie.
I think we do, too.
Let's go get some T-shirts. Come on, let me hear you loud and proud if you want some T-shirts.
You got to cheer if you want a T. We'll be right back.
Every life moment, every milestone, every journey, all begin with just one.
One conversation.
One decision.
One risk.
One choice. No matter our age,
our background,
our gender.
Every day, we all have the power to choose just one action that propels us forward.
It doesn't have to be large, and we don't need to have it all figured out.
Change can feel like a daunting task at times.
Yet each of us can, just one step at a time.
Our individual steps are different.
Yet what unites us
is the power to make that one choice.
One chance.
One risk.
One moment of courage.
Let the games begin.
And then, imagine the collective strength of our individual just ones as a united national FFA organization and the impact to our chapters, communities, agriculture, and the larger future. It truly is up to each one of us.
Just one.
Just one.
Just one. Today. Who's ready?
Many friends of the FFA. It is my duty to see that the doors open to our friends at all times and that they are welcome. I care for the meeting room and paraphernalia. I strive to keep the room comfortable and assist the president in maintaining order.
The reporter.
The reporter is stationed by the flag.
Why by the flag?
As the flag covers the United States of America, so I strive to inform the people in order that every man, woman, and child may know that the FFA is a national organization that reaches from the states of Alaska to the Virgin Islands and from the states of Maine to Hawaii.
The treasurer.
Stationed at the emblem of Washington,
your duties there?
I keep a record of receipts and disbursements just as Washington kept his farm accounts carefully and accurately. I encourage thrift among the members and strive to build up our financial standing through savings and investments. George Washington was better able to serve his country because he was financially independent.
The Secretary.
Stationed by the ear of corn.
Your duties there?
I keep an accurate record of all meetings and correspond with other secretaries wherever corn is grown and FFA members meet.
The Advisor.
Here by the owl.
Why stationed by the owl?
The owl is a time-honored emblem of knowledge and wisdom. Being older than the rest of you, I'm asked to advise you from time to time as the need arises. I hope that my advice will always be based on true knowledge and ripened with wisdom. Madam Vice President, why do you keep a plow at your station?
The plow is the symbol of labor and tillage of the soil. Without labor, neither knowledge nor wisdom can accomplish much. My duties require me to assist at all times in directing the work of our organization. I preside over meetings in the absence of our president, whose place is beneath the rising sun.
Why is the president so stationed?
The rising sun is the token of a new era in agriculture. If we will follow the leadership of our president, we shall be led out of the darkness of selfishness and into the glorious sunlight of brotherhood and cooperation. Mr. President, all officers are at their stations.
Thank you, Madam Vice President. The Secretary will call the roll of members.
I am pleased to announce that there are 5,696 members, advisors, and guests registered at the 91st Georgia FFA Convention, Mr. President.
Thank you. FFA members, why are we here? To practice brotherhood, honor agricultural opportunities and responsibilities, and develop those qualities of leadership which an FFA member should possess. May we accomplish our purposes. I now declare this fourth general session of the 91st Georgia FFA Convention duly open for the transaction of business or attention to any matter which may properly be presented. Our next session chair is a connoisseur of all things fashion, Beyonce, and all things FFA camp related. During our year of service, she has served Georgia FFA by being a shining light of positivity to everyone she meets. Whether it's the livestock barn or at an FFA dance at the camp, she can be found with a smile on her face and an outfit, as she likes to say, is on fleek. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to welcome State Vice President from the Eastside FFA chapter, Ava Jane Teasley.
I have lived, breathed, and slept camp. From blobbing to chicken tenders, camp is in my blood. Living at the Georgia FFA FCCLA Center was my normal, and when school got out for summer, I was ready. Hitching rides on the mobile canteen, boogieing to the cha-cha slide, painting pigs at a craft shop, the possibilities were endless. But I have to say, my favorite part about living on camp was watching so many students and their advisors work together to reach the common goal of Team of the Week and Leadership Team of the Week. So prepare yourselves, because as of right now, you're loading that big yellow Twinkie to have the best week of your entire life at Summer Leadership Camp. Woo! Grab hold of your sunscreen, get ready to hoop and holler, because we're going to camp. This session is sponsored by the Georgia FFA FCCLA Center. I know, ironic. We are so thankful for the support and opportunities that the FFA Center provides for FFA members like Summer Leadership Camp or SLC. But camp is not just a summer event. The planning and preparation is a year-long process that so many people invest in to make sure you have a life-changing week during the summer. If you would, turn your attentions to the screen.
Well, there was a video that was going to be played, but I think y'all watched it before session, right? Y'all watch a video before session about camp? We're so thankful for all the support that the FFA Center has done for all of our members and what they will do in the future. During this session, we'll get to hear from our favorite old soul who loves Mexican food, singing to every song of the book and FFA members, our Southern Region State Vice President, Dawson Adams. We'll get to recognize Georgia FFA's Team of the Weeks, AKA chapters who have filled out top-notch national chapter applications. We'll get to recognize 13 newly chartered chapters and announce the winner of our talent competition. During our last moments at camp, we'll go into a business session where we will hear the potential team captains of the 2019-2020 State FFA Officer Team. So FFA members, prepare for your ag teacher to leave late, someone to forget their charger and sunburns for days, as we go into this, the fourth general session of the 91st Georgia FFA Convention.
Just one chance, just one moment to change the course. It's time we show it, raise a voice.
Living at camp, I've learned a few things and secrets. Like, did you know that on Wednesdays during SLC, advisors go to a secret dinner where they get fed steak? Yeah, not fair. But I will say that at these dinners, there are many guest speakers that are brought in to talk about opportunities for our students. This next guest speaker also strives to build opportunities for all students. He values agricultural education, our teachers, and you. Born in Florida to a military family, he lived in California, Virginia, and Hawaii before landing here in Georgia. After graduating from Fitzgerald High School in Fitzgerald, Georgia, he attended Kennesaw State University, where he received his bachelor's, and Valdosta State University, where he received his master's. He's been a servant in public education for the past 24 years, 14 years serving as a teacher, and over the course of 8 years serving as a curriculum director, testing coordinator, assistant principal, and principal. In 2015, he was elected to serve as our state school superintendent, and we are so excited to have him here today. Please join me in welcoming the Honorable Richard Woods.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. It's a pleasure to be with you once again. This is the fifth year I've had the pleasure of being with you during the conference, and each year I think it keeps getting better and better. We continue to look and move forward. I think when I first came on board to say that hopefully one day we'll have 50,000 members of FFA throughout the state of Georgia, I think that would be a great target to shoot for. But I do want to say congratulations to what you do each and every day. You are definitely the cream of the crop of what we are producing in education. As I have shared before, as a teacher, when I saw a blue and gold jacket in my classroom, I never worried at all about those students. They were the highest performing students. They were the students that really were the leaders. And so I appreciate your work, and again, for you being the leaders within your school. And as you look at winding down this school year, I know a lot of things are going on. For those of you who are seniors, we wish you the very best. I hope you will continue to be engaged with us. We also have the Young Farmers Organization that continues to support our FFA, and be thinking about that. And hopefully what you'll find out is that there are a lot of great opportunities and jobs and careers in agribusiness. It's not just getting in a tractor and just plowing up a field, but there are a lot of great things out there that you can do to support the largest industry in the state of Georgia. Once again, it's a pleasure to be with you. I know you will have a great conference. You're looking forward, I think, to the dance tonight as well. So there's nothing wrong with all work and no play, definitely adding some of that into there. So again, thank you for the privilege of being with you. We look forward to coming back for the next several years. And again, we look forward to much, much success. And if I could be of help, please let me know. Thank you.
Superintendent Woods, Thank you for joining us here at the 91st Georgia FFA State Convention. Your support for agricultural education and the over 42,000 FFA members does not go unnoticed. I hope you accept this token of our appreciation. Ladies and gentlemen, Superintendent Richard Woods. One of my favorite parts of camp is the talent competition. From judging it when I was only 7 years old to actually being in it, the talent competition was always entertaining. Needless to say, this next individual makes me feel right at home. Georgia FFA, welcome our next FFA talent.
Hi, my name's Caitlin Ritchie, and I'm from the Southeast Bullock FFA chapter.
I've heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah, 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 strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to her kitchen chair. She broke your throne. She cut your hair. And from your lips, she drew.
Somebody who out
It's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. So cold and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Your next speaker is one whom in his freshman year of high school was not completely sold out to the National FFA organization. He was an active officer and member in our local chapter, but he was also one who competed in our school system's weightlifting team. One day he had to make a decision though, attend national convention with us or go to a regional weightlifting competition. I'll never forget the day that Dawson came to me and said, "Sign me up, I'm going with y'all to national convention." With a smile on my face, I proudly said, "Son, I already have." The rest of that year was a learning curve for Dawson. He went on to compete in the state junior prepared public speaking at the state convention, but didn't place. Ran for area office, but didn't get elected. Instead of allowing these setbacks to determine his success, he continued to write his song.
By 10th grade, he had harnessed the skill for speech writing and public presentation. He made many memories along the way, standing out in front of our school's flagpole, leading his peers in praise and worship. It makes a proud advisor to see their student compete at nationals, but even prouder to see them strong in their faith. To be honest, many of our memories exist between songs of Reba McEntire and Randy Travis, over Chinese food, and the occasional wonderful chance I get to listen him play piano in an empty church sanctuary.
It is an honor for us to introduce to you your 2018-2019 South Region State FFA Vice President.
And my brother.
Our student, with his retiring address, write your song,
Dawson Adams.
It seems like that no matter how far from home I roam, I can find a piano anywhere, and I mean anywhere. From the National FFA Convention in Indianapolis, Indiana, to the Georgia FFA FCCLA Center, to Bryce's family's house in Dunellen, Florida, it never fails. And if there's one thing that I've learned about piano and playing music, is that a piano is so much more than an instrument. If we look a little closer, we can see so much knowledge and wisdom based on each note that we play. And I grew up in a somewhat musical family. My great-great-aunt Betty can play about anything you throw at her on piano. My papa played piano and led the choir. My daddy plays bass, and most of my cousins sing. And every Sunday, you'll find my whole family at church. And I'll never forget one Sunday in particular. The church service that day was fantastic. The whole congregation was worshiping, and my Papa Randy played one of his classics, which went like this.
Oh no, the old story will never grow old, how Jesus died to save my soul. Oh no, the old story will never grow old, that story will never grow old.
And after church, we all went back to my nanny's house for Sunday lunch. And after a delicious home-cooked meal, my six-year-old self and my entire family gathered around the piano and played and sang songs out of the church hymnal like I'll Fly Away and Victory in Jesus. And I can remember the joy that would enter that room and the smiles on all of my family's faces as my great Aunt Betty would lead us into one more chorus. It was so easy to sit in that environment and play piano all afternoon. And as I've gotten older, I've realized just how much music and life go hand in hand. You see, it's so easy to sit and play on a Sunday afternoon when everything is going right. Just like it's easy to hold your head up when you just won your CDE, and it's easy to smile when you just got elected to that officer team you always wanted to be on. When success and blessings are flowing your way, it's so easy to continue your song. Use the moments when the music naturally flows to create a melody that others want to hear. Now, we've had the opportunity to travel all over this great state this year. I've been to Atlanta and seen the Capitol, and I've driven back roads in South Georgia with beautiful sunsets behind me. But one of the most impactful experiences happened in the aftermath of disaster. Back in November, on the business and industry tour, we had the opportunity to travel down to Camilla, Georgia. And as we begin to drive down the road, we begin to see pecan orchards completely uprooted, light lines laying on the ground, houses with tarps on them, greenhouses shredded, and cotton laying flat on the ground. Disaster from Hurricane Michael was everywhere, and no matter how hard the farmers tried to prepare for it, the situation was out of their control. With their livelihoods crumbled, it began to become hard for the farmers to focus on the keys because some out-of-tune notes had made its way into their song. They felt like they were all alone. When you play piano, you know, it's fun to sit and play songs you know and make up songs, but somewhere along the way, we start hitting wrong notes. Failure. It happens. There are two types of failure. The kind that comes from a lack of preparation and the kind that comes due to your environment. You see, there's a difference in hitting the keys so hard that your strings break and having your strings break unexpectedly like the farmers of Southwest Georgia. We have to strive for things to go right and not set ourselves up for failure. But when those unexpected events happen, they can make us want to get up and quit. When have you hit the wrong notes? Maybe it was when you walked out of your CDE room and forgot every line of the FFA creed. Or maybe you didn't make that team you always wanted to be on. Or got an F when the teacher handed you back your tests. Or had to stand at the end of the line in the livestock arena. I've been there. And trust me, when failure happens, it's so hard to continue our song. And somewhere along the way, we can even begin to think that our songs have come to an end. Wrong notes. Yeah, they happen. But they can add a beautiful harmony to our melody. After those right and wrong notes, we have to sit back down and form the most beautiful song. You know, my Papa Randy is one of the most incredible people that I have ever met. And in 2001, he was diagnosed with renal cell carcinoma, a form of cancer that attacks the kidneys. Those dreaded words, "You have cancer," the words that no one wants to hear, had been spoken to my Papa. We were devastated. How could this be? Our families rocked. The man who had done everything right, now had cancer? Oh, but my Papa, he used those words as notes to form a song that he didn't yet know the ending to, but he knew the outcome. My Papa played because he knew there was somebody out there that needed to hear the melody. He knew there was somebody out there that had things worse off than he did. He knew there was somebody out there that he needed to show the love of Jesus to. He knew there was somebody out there that needed to experience the joy we had so often shared around his piano. For somebody out there, he had to get back up and continue to play. And after an 8-year battle, my Papa's time on this earth ended. But if you were to have met my papa, you wouldn't have known that he was in pain and cancer had inflicted his body by the way that he acted and showed every person love. Even in his last days, my papa would take the time to thank the creator of life for the life he had lived. The song he played was a joyful song. He left this earth having touched the lives of many, including his students, our church family, our community members, and those at the nursing homes all across South Georgia who would so often gather around to worship with him. The notes that he played continue to resonate in my family and even in this convention hall today. My Papa Randy's song, "Oh No, the Old Story Will Never Grow Old, How Jesus Died to Save My Soul," lives on. You see, the point is really simple. Our lives are not to be lived for ourselves. No, our lives are to be spent serving others in the good times, in the bad times, and in the in-between times. Our song is our legacy. Through disaster, disease, heartache, pain, love, joy, and all the moments in between, we are to play our song. When we finally see our songs as lives full of service, we can truly see it come to life. Each beat, each measure, each right and wrong note. Georgia FFA, how will you write your song?
Reverend Dawson, who knows what we would have done without your big heart, love for the elderly, and perfectly styled red hair. Your love for livestock, photography, and FFA members does not go unnoticed. Although your ability to sniff out a piano is impressive, but it's nowhere near as impressive as your ability to inspire others. You are the best storyteller that this team and association has ever had. Love always, Doster, Clay, Brittany, Thomas, Emily, Bryce, and Ava Jane. Georgia FFA, your 2018-2019 South Region State Vice President from the Coffee County FFA chapter, Dawson Adams. Talent show, someone is always crowned the winner. Now, they may not get a big, shiny, sparkly trophy, but they do get to snack on camp chicken tenders and banana pudding. And if you ask me, that is way better. But luckily for us here at State Convention, we are able to hear from tons of talented FFA members. But there can only be one winner. So all I gotta say is, please remember me when you make it big. All right, just saying. Georgia FFA has voted, and the results are in. Mr. Secretary, will you please read the names of our fifth annual Georgia FFA Talent Competition winner?
The FFA Talent Competition finalists will receive a trophy and a $25 iTunes gift card, and the winner will receive a trophy and a $100 iTunes gift card. Before we announce the winner, let's meet all the contestants who participated. The finalists are Ian Bailey from the Cairo High School FFA chapter, Joyana McDonald, a member of the Appalachie FFA chapter, Carter Millis of the Locust Grove FFA chapter, and finally, Brooke Brown and Hayden Pollard, members of the Mount Zion FFA chapter. And the winner of our state FFA talent competition is Brooke Brown and Hayden Pollard of the Mount Zion FFA chapter. Congratulations to all of our finalists in the talent competition.
Firsts are always something to remember. Whether it's your first trip with the FFA or your first time attending camp. These next few chapters have experienced their first with being a part of Georgia FFA. They are the new seasoned camper of our association, and we are proud to add them to our ranks. Blood, sweat, and tears have gone in to get them where they are today, and we even have a piece of paper to prove it. 13 newly chartered chapters began their charter this past fall and have joined our family and association. Madam Vice President, will you please read the names of the chapters who began their charter this past fall?
Madam Vice President, it is an honor to read the names of those chapters receiving new charters. From the North Region, Commerce Middle, Denmark. Thank you. Thank you. East Paulding. Lumpkin County Middle. Raven County Middle. From the Central Region, Georgia School for the Innovation and the Classics, Southeast Bullock Middle, and from the South Region, Camden County Middle, Citizens Christian Academy, St. Mary's Middle, Sumter County Middle, congratulations to all of our newly installed chapters.
Camp is the best week of the summer. Let me hear you if you agree. I can only think of two other events that can create such a large amount of memories in such a short amount of time. Obviously, state convention, but my favorite week of the school year, National FFA Week. I love getting the whole school together to dress up and participate in service project so we can showcase what our organization is all about. Chapters are able to celebrate their success, but also set new goals for the future. Chapters who fill out National FFA Week applications put in pictures and articles and other evidence to support all the unique things that they have done during National FFA Week. Mr. Secretary, will you please read the names of the chapters who filled out top-notch FFA Week applications?
The 2019 National FFA Week Observance Awards are sponsored by Titan Goodyear Farm Tires, and the three state finalists have been named. The results are, the third place winner receiving a plaque is the Tiff County FFA chapter. Our state runner-up receiving a cash award of $250 is the Jefferson Middle FFA chapter. And the state winner of the 2019 National FFA Week Observance Award receiving $500 is the Cambridge FFA chapter. The chapter advisor will also receive $100 for this accomplishment.
Congratulations.
Madam Vice President, these are our 2019 National FFA Week Observance Award winners.
week long during camp, chapters go head to head in competitions, ball games, and advisors' challenges to get as many points as possible to stay in the lead for Team of the Week. From cleaning up after breakfast to staying quiet during reflections, chapters do everything they can to stay in the lead. Now, we may not recognize a Team of the Week here at State Convention, but these next chapters surely exemplify what it means to be a part of a team. The National Chapter Award application recognizes those who have filled out a report showcasing the 12 best and most unique activities that they have done throughout the school year. The top 10% of applications are named Gold Emblem Chapters. Applications are scored on the area level, and the top area applications are then scored for the state level. Gold Emblem Chapters are able to be sent nationally to be named a 1, 2, or 3-star chapter. Madam Vice President, will you please read the names of our National Chapter Award application winners?
It is a pleasure to recognize our 2019 Chapter Achievement winners and Gold Emblem Chapters. The Chapter Achievement Awards are sponsored by Farm Credit Associations of Georgia. Each of our area chapter achievement winners will receive a plaque and a $150 cash award. The state winner this morning will receive a plaque and $500 for their chapter. Their local advisor will also receive $100 for this accomplishment. Winning Area 1 is the Cambridge FFA chapter. The Area 2 winner and state winner is the Jefferson Middle FFA chapter. Representing Area 3 is the Northside Middle FFA chapter. The Area 4 winner of chapter achievement is West Lawrence Middle FFA chapter.
Congratulations.
Our Area 5 winner is the Batala Charter FFA chapter.
Congratulations.
And winning Area 6 in chapter achievement is the Berrien County FFA chapter. Congratulations to all of our area winners in the National Chapter Achievement Awards. Madam Vice President, we would now like to introduce all of the chapters who received a gold emblem ranking for all of the 2018-2019 school year. From the South Region, Atkinson County, Berrien County, Batala Charter, from the Central Region, Bonaire Middle, Crawford County, Islands, Locust Grove, Northside Middle, Perry Middle, Pike County, Screven County, Screven County Middle, Southeast Bullock, Stockbridge, West Lawrence Middle, and from the North Region, Appalachie, Cambridge, Carver Middle, Coahuila Creek, Commerce Middle, east side. Franklin County Middle. Jackson County. Jefferson Middle. Lafayette Middle. Madison County Middle. Morgan County Middle. Newton College and Career Academy. Oconee County. Pepperell. Russell Middle. West Jackson Middle. And finally, Youth Middle. Congratulations to all of our National Chapter Award recipients.
Now, I mentioned earlier about how I competed in the talent competition, but there's a reason I only competed in it once. Because my talent is nowhere near as good as others in the FFA. And luckily, we have them here today at State Convention. Georgia FFA, join me in welcoming our next FFA talent.
My name is Joyanna McDonald, and I'm representing the Appalachian FFA chapter.
Where we begin, I can't begin to know it, but then I know it's growing strong. And what did the spring, and then spring became the summer, who I believe will come along. Touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you, so we get alive. Good times never seem so good, and I've been inclined to be.
To be
if camp is not new to you, then you remember the time standing outside of Mobley Hall with smoke machines filling the air, hype music busting your eardrums, and one of my favorite people decked out in black eye paint, ready to go to war. And war, I mean the mud obstacle course. As we prepare for the mud obstacle course now, by all means do we not want this next part of our session to get messy or have mud slinging, but be prepared to understand why we are known to be the largest student-led organization as we open up the delegate business session. I now call the business meeting to order. During this business session, we will approve the members pursuing a state FFA degree, receive the nominating and state convention committee reports, and hear from the state officer candidates that so desperately want to serve you this next year. Delegates, you are the voice of your chapter. You have been chosen to represent your chapter and hold the responsibility of making positive changes within the FFA. It is important to keep in mind the decision that you make today affects over more than 42,000 FFA members across our state. Thank you for your service and dedication to improving our state and association. Each chapter in the state of Georgia has been given the opportunity to seat delegates on the floor to do the work of our association. Delegates, we are about to call the roll of chapters. It is crucial that you listen carefully to all instructions to ensure that your vote is counted. Mr. Secretary, will you please officially call the roll?
Delegates, the state convention staff is now checking the roll of chapters. Please remain seated in your official delegate chairs so that we can get an accurate listing of all delegates. Remember, the number of votes that your chapter will be allowed will be the same number of delegates that we recognize this afternoon. Listen carefully for any announcements concerning your chapter.
The FFA Horse Camp is a week-long residential summer camp for girls ages 10 through 13. It's a horse camp hosted by the Georgia FFA FCCLA Center. The goal of this program is to increase safety, awareness, and appreciation of horses in an exciting and dynamic environment. They get lots of practice in all aspects of horsemanship, from handling and grooming to riding at a walk and a trot. For more information, go to FFAHorseCamp.com.
The FFA Wildlife Camp is a week-long residential summer camp for boys and girls hosted by the Georgia FFA FCCLA Center. The program is centered on firearm and hunter safety. Participants will receive their hunter safety certification during their week of camp. They will also get lots of practice in shooting sports in a safe environment under the supervision of certified instructors. They will practice shooting shotguns, 22 rifles, and archery. Other aspects of the program include fishing techniques, fish cleaning and cooking, wildlife education, deer stand safety, habitat construction, and wildlife survival. For more information on the FFA Wildlife Camp, visit wildlifecamp.com.
Delegates, the following chapters have no delegates present. From the North Region, Campbell, Cherokee County, North Paulding, Pleasant Valley, Warren Technical. From the Central Region, Baldwin County, Central of Talbot, Fullington Academy, Gardner Newman Middle, Harlem, Spalding County, Twiggs County, Warren County. From the South Region, America Sumter North, Randolph Clay. Delegates, the following chapters have only one delegate present. From the South Region, Telfair County. If you are an official delegate from any of the chapters mentioned, please report to the secretary station immediately.
Thank you.
Madam Vice President, there are 651 voting delegates present.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. I now declare the delegates of the 91st Georgia FFA Convention officially seated. At SLC, the other prestigious award is the LTOW, or Leadership Team of the Week. Campers clean the dining hall, show integrity, and cheer for all chapters. For FFA members, the coveted state FFA degree is the ultimate reward. FFA members have worked relentlessly to meet the requirements to be able to wear this chain. Many hours have been put into their SAE and other activities in order to be considered for this degree. According to the Georgia FFA Constitution and bylaws, the Executive Secretary of the Georgia FFA Association must review the candidates for the state FFA degree and submit them to the delegates at the state meeting. Delegates, a list of the 2019 state degree recipients was sent to all agricultural teachers 2 weeks prior to state convention. This afternoon, you, the voting delegates, need to approve the 2019 state degree recipients. 762 applications were submitted and have been approved by the state FFA advisor. Is there a motion to approve the 2019 recipients of the state FFA degree?
My name is Trace Lammer from the Eastside FFA chapter. Madam Chair, I move to accept this list of 2019 recipients of the state FFA degree.
Is there a second? It has been moved and properly seconded to approve the 2019 recipients of the state FFA degree. Is there any debate? Seeing none, we will now proceed to vote. All those in favor of approving the 2019 recipients of the state FFA degree, please say aye. All opposed say no. The motion to approve the 2019 state FFA degree recipients passes. As we sit on our bunk beds and the advisors dodge in and around the cabin to take the votes, we are about to announce our team captains. Now, when it comes to summer camp, there are only three, but today we select eight. While at camp each morning, captains are able to eat breakfast with camp staff in order to make camp a positive experience for everyone. These individuals will be responsible for meeting and representing Georgia FFA to make it a better organization for each of you. Candidates, thank you for your dedication and hard work thus far. The candidates have been tested on their FFA knowledge through a written exam, experienced three strenuous interviews, and have had time to get to know some of you, the voting delegates. Now, their final step in this journey has brought them here to the 91st Georgia FFA State Convention. This morning, we heard the names of those candidates on stage, and now it is time to find out which of them have moved on to the next stage. Our next item of business will allow 12 members the possibility of serving for the state FFA officer team. Mr. Secretary, do you have a report concerning the nominating committee?
Madam Vice President, I am pleased to announce the following names that have been selected by the nominating committee to advance forward in the state FFA officer election process. From the North region, Cody Bias of Dawson County FFA. Brooklyn Carr of Sonorville FFA. Noel Plunkett of Jackson County FFA. And Kylie Whitworth of Madison County FFA. From the Central region, Caitlin Davis of South Effingham FFA. Spin Oliver of Harris County FFA. Lizzie Parks of Blakely County FFA. And Eric Robinson of Effingham County FFA. From the South region, Kirk Beecham of Colquitt County FFA. Ivy Cook of Tipp County FFA. Maddie Ann Davis of Brantley County FFA. and Justin Sandlin of Eccles County FFA.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary, and best of luck to each of our 12 candidates. Earlier today, a group of 12 FFA members and three advisors representing the North, Central, and South regions met at State Convention Review Committee to discuss how to make our future convention experience even better than the past. The State Executive Committee appointed the members of this committee and its advisors. The committee will now give us their report. Once they have presented their report, the chairperson will move to accept the report as read. Because it is a committee report, it carries an implied second. The report will then be open for discussion by you, the voting delegates. I will assume the lectern at that point, and questions can be directed towards me, the committee chair. Will Caitlin Hart of the Cockpit County FFA chapter, the chair of the State Convention Committee, come forward and present the committee report?
Madam Vice President, I am proud to present the State Convention Committee report for the 91st Georgia FFA Convention. The State Convention Committee met this afternoon with the following members present: Avery Bray of the Madison County Middle FFA Chapter, Peyton Jackson of the Banks County FFA Chapter, Gracie Sexton of the Sonoraville FFA Chapter, Philip Babin of the Effingham County FFA Chapter, Kirsten Coleman of the Montgomery County FFA Chapter, Britt Patel of the South Effingham Middle FFA Chapter, Trey Garbett of the Perry FFA Chapter, Tristan Carter of the Eccles County FFA Chapter, Landon Exum of the Berrien County Middle FFA Chapter, Olivia Spooner of the Seminole County FFA Chapter, and me, Chairman Caitlin Hart of the Colquitt County FFA Chapter. Advisors present included Ms. Ashley Denton of the Perry FFA and Mr. Dusty Smith of the Seminole County FFA. The committee submits the following recommendations and comments for the Georgia FFA Convention: looking into more interactive activities between sessions and possibly allowing the career show to continue into Friday, moving community service to Wednesday evening and possibly having an on-site community service project, exploring more modern ways for delegates to vote on state officer candidates, looking into multiple ways to live stream the sessions, keeping the convention in a centralized location and possibly looking into a different location as the Georgia National Fairgrounds. We enjoy the state officers' excitement, creativity, and personalities as they presented their sessions and retiring addresses. Finally, we would like to thank the City of Macon, as well as the State Agricultural Education and State Convention staff, for the effort they put into this convention. Madam Vice President, I move to accept this report as presented. Respectfully submitted, Caitlin Hart, Chairman.
There is an implied second for the committee report. Is there any discussion of the State Convention Committee report? Seeing none, we will proceed to vote on the State Convention Committee report. All those in favor of accepting the committee report as read, please say aye. All opposed, say no. The motion to accept the State Convention Committee report passes. Caitlin, thank you for serving as the chair of the State Convention Committee. Your hard work and dedication will ensure the annual State FFA Convention is a success. Also, thank you to the advisors and all members of the State Convention Committee. You are about to hear from 12 candidates to help you determine who will become the 8 members of the 2019-2020 State Officer Team. Delegates, please pay careful attention to the speeches that will be presented. After all 12 candidates have presented their speeches, they will return on stage and stand by region. You, the delegates, will vote for 2 vice presidents from each region. We will begin from hearing from the candidates from the South region, followed by the Central region, and finally candidates from the North region. Will the first candidate from the South region please come forward?
Hello, Georgia FFA.
I'm Kirk Beecham, and I proudly represent the Cochran County FFA chapter. Now, I was thinking, what does Georgia FFA truly need in a state officer? Do we need someone with the athletic ability of Freddie Freeman to hit home runs or Jake Fromm to throw touchdown passes? How about someone with the creativity of a good Snapchat filter? Maybe even someone with the singing ability of the King of Country, George Strait. Maybe we need someone with the ability to hold your attention as much as that good game of Fortnite. Maybe we need someone with the dancing ability of me. In all seriousness, though, I definitely don't possess all of these qualities, but I do have a sincere passion for this organization, a desire to work for the benefit of our membership, and some pretty sweet dance moves. My dad used to have a sign in his classroom that says, "Success is like a ladder. It cannot be climbed with your hands in your pockets." This means that if we want to be truly successful, we must be willing to put in that work to achieve that success. Georgia FFA, I want to work hard for you this year to make this association the best it can be. So remember this, I rarely smirk and I certainly don't twerk, but I will work for you. So don't be a jerk, vote for Kirk because he will work for you. Thank you.
Cookhouse, the TV show The Turtle Man, is an all-time family favorite. The Turtle Man would capture harmful animals with his own bare hands. It didn't matter if it was a possum or a snake, the Turtle Man was always there. The Turtle Man sounds a little bit crazy, but it's so cool, and I wanted to be just like him. Joshua 1:9 says, "Be strong and courageous. Don't be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." This verse sustains me daily, but can you imagine this short girl at 5'2" catching a snapping turtle or trapping a skunk? I don't think so. However, for Turtle Man, no matter how big or small, he was never afraid to step out of his comfort zone and go after that next wild animal to help a friend. My desire is to be that kind of officer for you, one that will go the extra mile to help and encourage you to step out of your comfort zone and go after that next CDE, SAE project, officer position, or other award that is waiting ahead. And like Turtle Man, I'll never leave your side. I'll always be here when you need me. Thank you for helping me find my purpose of live action through this great organization. FFA members, I might not be the Turtle Man, but I'm ready to help you, Georgia FFA, come alive and strive. To get lively and vote for Ivy. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Georgia FFA. I'm Maddie Ann Davis, and I proudly represent the Brantley County High School FFA chapter. Someone once told me the best way to get to know someone is to find out what they're fans of. So I figured I would ask that question here at convention. Do we have any Braves fans? What about Chick-fil-A fans? And of course, where are all the Georgia Bulldog fans? That is definitely me. At the age of 3, I was convinced I was a Georgia Bulldogs cheerleader. As fate would have it, a family road trip found us in Tennessee. You know the scene. Family riding along, singing songs, playing I Spy. Then it happened. Two Tennessee college girls rode by my window, their car decked with gaudy orange bumper stickers. I did the only thing I knew to do. I had to tell them who was the greatest team in all the nation. With my pigtails flapping in the wind, I threw up my spirit fingers and yelled, "Georgia's number one." Well, 4 broken arms and a less than perfect 10 cartwheel later, I found out I was no Georgia cheerleader. True to Jeremiah 29:11, God's plans took me to a different place. I began going to their competitions, wearing their t-shirts, buying the bumper stickers, and of course, the jacket. Team Georgia FFA became my deep-rooted passion, so I figured I've landed amongst the greatest fans in all the nation. When I say young to old fans of the blue and gold, where are all my Georgia FFA fans? Let's take this team to the top. Vote your biggest fan. Vote Maddie Ann.
Georgia FFA, do you like to cha-cha slide? Everyone get up on your feet. Get up, get up, get up. Everybody clap your hands. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Everybody clap your hands. I am Justin Salen from the Eccles County FFA chapter. Just as the cha-cha slide has many different moving parts, the FFA does too. Whether it be members like all of you today or preparing and promoting the agricultural industry, our hands are our key to service. Whether it be shaking hands with governing officials or speaking on a topic we are passionate about, our hands are our gateway to service. If elected to your Georgia FFA State Officer team, I will serve you, Georgia FFA, hand and foot. So in casting your vote, relax and remember, hand in the Sandlin. That's me, Justin Sandlin, for your 2019-2020 Georgia FFA State Officer team. And everybody remember, get up on your feet. Come on, come on, woo! Everybody clap your hands.
Will the candidates from the Central Region please come forward?
What's up, Georgia FFA? My name is Caitlin Davis, and I'm proudly representing the South Effingham High School FFA chapter. Now, I have a question for y'all. How many of you hate waiting? How many of you had to wait hours on a bus ride to get up here Wednesday or Thursday? How many of y'all have already waited in those long lines for food or for Dippin' Dots or Starbucks? How many of my girls have already got a run in their pantyhose and had to wait to go and change them? And how many of my guys had to hear all about it while those girls were waiting? Well, Georgia FFA, I've been waiting on this moment since I sat in those very same seats out there in the seventh grade. And I have to admit, the view's pretty nice from up here. Georgia has some good-looking FFA members. It's crazy to look back and reflect on how much I've changed since the start of my FFA career. I've grown as a person and a leader all because of the inspiration that I received from the state officers. If elected to serve as a 2019-2020 State Central Region Vice President, I'd be able to light that same spark that was lit in me all those years ago at this very convention. So, don't keep Georgia FFA waiting and vote for Caitlin. Thank you.
Hello, Georgia FFA. My name is Spen Oliver, and I am proudly representing the Harris County FFA chapter. I am dizzy with excitement to be here with this sea of blue corduroy jackets at the 91st State FFA Convention. I don't know about y'all, but I love game shows. Whether I'm watching Family Feud or Jeopardy, I try and picture myself in the game. One of my favorite game shows is The Wheel of Fortune. I love to watch the excited contestants stand around the table and wait for their chance to spin the FFA, their Wheel of Fortune. FFA members, each time you put on this blue corduroy jacket, you have your opportunity to take your spin on the FFA Wheel of Fortune. And each day represents an opportunity that can change your life. While you may not win that car or the trip to the Bahamas, you have the opportunity to travel and compete in the FFA. Whether it's state ag sales in Fort Valley, Washington Leadership Conference in Washington, D.C., or even right here in Macon at the State FFA Convention, there is so much to see and do. The experience is priceless. I want to make sure that each and every FFA member in this state takes their opportunity to spin their FFA Wheel of Fortune. Georgia FFA, I would sincerely appreciate your vote to allow me, Spin Oliver, to serve you as a 2019-2020 State FFA Officer Team member. And remember, for the win, vote for Spin. Thank y'all.
Good afternoon, Georgia FFA. My name is Lizzie Parks, and I am proudly representing the Bleckley County FFA chapter. A lot of you know me as Frizzy Lizzie, obviously because of my crazy curly hair. But there are a few other things that make me who I am. I love iced coffee, FFA, jamming to music, and Jesus. FFA members have a few things that make them carry a special tune. So let's get down to business. Imagine driving a brand new Chevy with a lift kit, jamming to some good old country music. Doesn't that sound like heaven? Maybe you are an FFA member that likes to go down to the honky tonk, or maybe you're like me and you like your chicken fried, but with sweet tea at Chick-fil-A on CDE nights. Now, I only have 2 minutes, but I wish you could give me 5 more minutes because I never get tired of talking about FFA. So while you are in the business of taking your vote to the Old Sound Road, don't put your vote on shuffle and pick just any song. Sing the song of Frizzy Lizzie Parks. Vote Lizzie Parks as your 2019-2020 Georgia FFA State Vice President. And remember, take care of Biz and vote for Liz. Thank you.
What's going on, Georgia FFA? My name is Eric Robinson, and I'm from the Effingham County High School FFA chapter. Now, before I begin, Emily, you did it okay, but let me show you how it's done. How many of you have seen The Lion King? For those of you who have not seen the movie, first of all, what are you doing? Second of all, let me give you a little breakdown. It's the story of a young cub named Simba who suffers tragedy at a young age, which takes him into the unknown. But in this unknown, he meets two people, two animals, Timon and Pumbaa. Timon and Pumbaa help him along his journey and bring him back to Pride Rock. I relate to Simba in so many ways. Obviously, not because of my glowing mane, but I relate to Simba because whenever I was in seventh grade, I suffered something that changed my life completely. I became injured after playing sports, and it ended my sports career. But I rallied. I met my ag teacher, Mr. Lanier, and he brought me into the world of FFA, and I never looked back. Now, before I leave stage, I'm going to give you some of the best advice that's ever been given on cinema. Hakuna Matata means no worries for the rest of your days. And a vote for Eric Robinson means no worries for Georgia FFA. Thank you.
Will the first candidate from the North Region please come forward?
Good evening, Georgia FFA. My name is Cody Bias, and the first thing I would like to ask you is how many of y'all love Chick-fil-A? Right. So I'd like to inform y'all that I have had the pleasure of working at that holy institution for almost 2 years now. And yeah, you're thinking, oh my gosh, he just said he has had the pleasure of working there. One of the biggest questions I've heard is, do they force y'all to say that? And I'm just like, no, it's not a say it or be fired kind of situation, but it's definitely desired. The reason that we say my pleasure at Chick-fil-A is dates back to Truett Cathy, our founder. Truett went to a hotel once in Las Vegas, and he stayed, and they said my pleasure when he said thank you, and it really just stuck with him. So one thing that I have learned at Chick-fil-A is that it really just makes it more personal. Now, one thing that I definitely can say now is that my pleasure brings a whole new meaning to me. It would be my pleasure to serve as one of y'all's state officers for 2019 through 2020. And just remember, Georgia FFA, don't think twice and vote for vice. And it would be my pleasure. Thank you.
Okay, let's shift it to the next gear. I am Brooklyn Carr from the Snorville High School FFA chapter. We all have choices. Ford or Chevy, Dodge or GMC. And despite the difference that may take us apart, or our personal preference, or what we took to get here, we are all here. An old proverb states, if you want to go quickly, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together. Although we could be able to go quickly and alone, if we go together, we will accomplish so many goals. And I want to focus on bringing us together. Don't dodge our challenges, but ram them. Let's go places, because we are built FFA tough. Don't push the brake. Let's make this year great. And you will all go far with Brooklyn Carr. Well, it's time for me to skirt out of here. Skirt, skirt!
Forty-three thousand smiles, 43,000 stories, 43,000 wins, 43,000 losses. Each one of us in this room has had at least one defining moment in our lives. And those seconds, however brief they may have been, have made us who we are. Hello, everyone. I'm Noelle Plunkett from the Jackson County FFA chapter. And as a shy sixth grader who was put into a class I knew nothing about, I had to force myself to ask, what is agriculture? Well, that question would soon be answered as I took a leap of faith and joined the West Jackson Middle FFA that everyone had been talking about. You see, each one of us in this room at this moment has made that choice, a choice that has brought us all right here, right now. So what are you going to do with this moment? As I look back through the memories that this organization has provided for all of us, I am so thankful. Thankful for the good times and the times where success was far away. Thankful for everyone in this room and the defining moments that got us all here. You are what makes this. So, Georgia FFA, remember when voting, you don't have to take the L. You could just vote for Noelle. Thank you.
All right, how many of you have ever been hiking? Okay. How many of you have ever walked up a hill that made you feel like you were hiking because you were out of shape? All right, I'm thinking of a specific mountain, so let's see if you can help me out. Picture this. You just got done busting a dance move on the floor. You footloose biker shuffled or even wowed your way into exhaustion. And now there's just one thing in between you and your bed. The mountain of all mountains, the hill at FFA camp. Now, we all know the hill at FFA camp is not a real mountain, but it sure can feel like one sometimes. However, in real life, we face mountains each and every day, whether that be ones we choose to hike or others we are forced to take. For me, it was a difficult show season and a proficiency that I had worked hard at and didn't advance to the next level. For you, it may be a sick family member or an athletic team that you didn't make. My mama has always told me that with faith, I can move mountains. Matthew 17:20 says that with faith as tiny as a mustard seed, you can tell this mountain to move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing is impossible for you. Georgia FFA, I want to be that person to remind you that with faith as tiny as a mustard seed, we can move mountains. whether that be increase the numbers within your chapter or diversity among your community development events, we can move mountains. So have faith in me, Kylie Faith Whitworth, to serve you as a Georgia State FFA officer, because what could we do with the faith of just one tiny mustard seed? Thank you.
Will the candidates please return to the stage according to region? Mr. Secretary, please introduce the candidates by region one more time.
From the North Region, Cody Bias of Dawson County, Brooklyn Carr of Sonorville, Noel Plunkett of Jackson County, Kylie Whitworth of Madison County. From the Central Region, Caitlin Davis of South Effingham, Spen Oliver of Harris County, Lizzie Parks of Bleckley County, and Eric Robinson of Effingham County. From the South Region, Kirk Beecham of the Colquitt County, Ivy Cook of Tift County, Maddie Ann Davis of Brantley County, and Justin Sandlin of Eccles County. Delegates, please look to the center aisle to receive your ballot. We will introduce each candidate one more time by region and allow you to vote. Circle only two names for vice president from each region. Do not fold the ballot more than once. Do not write your name on the ballot or circle more than two names from each region that are on the ballot. Once you have completed your ballot, pass it to the end of your row facing the center aisle. Please, no cheering or jeering. Madam Chairman, these are the 2019-2020 candidates for State FFA office. Candidates, please step forward when your name is announced. From the North Region, Cody Bias of Dawson County, Brooklyn Carr of Sonorville, Noel Plunkett of Jackson County, Kylie Whitworth of Madison County. From the Central Region, Caitlin Davis of South Effingham, Spen Oliver of Harris County, Lizzie Parks of Bleckley County, and Eric Robinson of Effingham County. From the South Region, Kirk Beecham of Colquitt County, Ivy Cook of Tift County, Maddie Ann Davis of Brantley County, and Justin Sandlin of Eccles County. If you have not received a ballot, please raise your hand at this time. If you have not received a ballot, please raise your hand. Delegates, circle only two names for vice president from each region. Do not fold the ballot more than once. Do not write your name on the ballot or circle more than two names from each region that are on the ballot. Once you have completed your ballot, pass it to the end of your row facing the center aisle. Also, pass your pencils as well. Please, no cheering or jeering. When you have completed your ballot, please pass it as well as your pencil to the center aisle. If you still have your voting ballot, please raise your hand. If you still have your ballot, please raise your hand at this time. Have all ballots been collected? If you still have your ballot, please raise your hand at this time. Convention staff, have all ballots been returned to the secretary station? All ballots have been collected.
Have all ballots been collected? If so, this concludes the balloting for the 2019-2020 State Vice Presidents. Best of luck to all of our candidates. Does any delegate have any new business for this session? Seeing none, the official business session of the 91st Georgia FFA Convention is closed, but lucky for you, our time at camp is not over yet. So wave your team flag and get ready to chant as we continue our ride at camp. Our team captains have picked up our crafts. We have one team of the week, and we are full on banana pudding. Our memories that we have made during camps are one that we will cherish for a lifetime. It seems like our ag teachers are telling us to load up on the bus as we pull out of 720 FFA FHA Camp Road. In the fourth general session, we got to hear from amazing talent competitors, some awesome chapters, and learn the names of the candidates who so desperately want to serve you this next year. With French toast in our stomachs and a nap for the ride home, we are about to end the fourth general session of the 91st Georgia FFA Convention. But lucky for you, the fun of convention is not over yet. So grab a fountain drink and wipe the sleep out of your eyes, because in the fifth general session, you'll get to hear from my fellow North Region Vice President and B aficionado, Doster Harper. We will also get to hear from our National Eastern Region Vice President from the Great Lakes State of Michigan, Miss Adrienne Shunk. We'll get to recognize the winners of our leadership development events and celebrate, in my opinion, the best decision FFA has ever made, allowing women in FFA. Woo! From the past 91 years, FFA members have been experiencing the power of just one. Just one opportunity, just one experience, just one moment can completely change the course of our lives. Just one mission of premier leadership, personal growth, and career success leads to fulfilling just one vision of growing leaders, building communities, and strengthening agriculture. All you need is just one you. Georgia FFA members see the power in just one. Please join me in welcoming back to the lectern State FFA President Bryce Rowland.
Mr. Secretary, do you have a record of any further business which should now be transacted?
Yes, I do. If you have lost an item, please report to the Secretary's station at the conclusion of this session. Again, if you have lost an item, please report to the Secretary's station at the conclusion of this session.
Does any member know of any new or unfinished business which should properly come before this session? We are about to adjourn this fourth general session of the 91st Georgia FFA Convention. As we mingle with others, let us be diligent in labor, just in our dealings, courteous to everyone, and above all, honest and fair in the game of life. Fellow members and guests, please join me in a salute to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I now declare this session adjourned.